In this video, I will talk a little bit about my favorite disk partitioning software, the Minitool Partition Wizard. I've known this tool since the first time I jailbroke my Xbox 360, which is about 10 years ago. So without further ado, let's get started. This video is supported by Minitool Solutions. You can go to their website to find other apps for your computer or your mobile phone. So head to the Minitool website, click Products, then Partition Manager, and select Partition Wizard Free Edition. Then click Download Freeware. And press the Start Download button. Double-click the downloaded installer. On this step, choose only Minitool Partition Wizard Free, and you don't have to enable other options. Then click Next. And press Next again to install the app. And then you can launch it. As soon as you press the button, it will automatically open the Minitool Partition Wizard site. Don't bother, just close it. On this section, I will show you some of the Minitool Partition Wizard features. So for example, I have a 128GB SD card, and I want to format it as FAT32. First, let's find out its file system. Select the drive and click Properties. As you can see, the file system is XFAT. And most of the people think that it is easy to format it as FAT32 using the built-in Windows format feature. But you cannot do it. Look at this. Right-click the drive, then select Format. There is no option to format it as FAT32. If you have a storage device larger than 32GB, then Windows won't let you format it as FAT32. Well, actually, it is possible, but it is hidden. And it is better to use an app to help you with it. And the good thing is, you can format your drive easily and do other operations with the Minitool Partition Wizard. As soon as you open the app, you can see all the drives on your computer. Now let's select the drive that we want to format it as FAT32. For my case, it is on disk 5, which is drive L. Right-click the drive, then select Format. You can fill in the partition label or ignore it, but you need to select FAT32 for the file system and leave the cluster size as default. Then click Apply to execute it. Now your drive is formatted as FAT32. It was easy, right? If you want to check the file system with Windows, be my guest. So it is confirmed that the drive is now formatted as FAT32. The next thing is useful if you have a Nintendo Wii or an Xbox 360. Suppose my drive is a USB hard drive and you have formatted as FAT32, but the console cannot detect the drive. For this case, you will need to check the partition ID of the selected drive. Right-click the drive, then select Change Partition Type ID. By the way, this feature is available if you buy this software. If you want to use it freely, then use the Minitool Partition Wizard version 10. Let's continue. As you can see, the partition type ID for this drive is currently set as NTFS. To make it work under Nintendo Wii or an Xbox 360, you should change this ID to Hexi FAT32LBA. Then click Yes. Then press Apply. If you want to reconfirm the partition type ID, you can open its properties. Now I'm sure your console will pick up the drive. The next feature is splitting the partition. If you want to use the same drive for games and movies, then it's better to split the partition. So right-click the drive, then choose Split. Now you can allocate how much space you need for each category by sliding the pointer to the left or the right. And if you have satisfied with it, press OK. If you want to set the newly allocated drive as other file system, then format it. Let's assume that we want to format the drive as NTFS. Press OK, then hit that Apply button. done. SCCS that. If someday we want to merge those drives, then each drive should have the same file system. Remember that one drive is NTFS and the other one is FAT32. Let's change or convert the FAT32 to NTFS. Right-click the drive, then just convert FAT to NTFS. Then press the start button. And then press close. Since both drives have the same file system, we can merge it. Right-click any drive, then choose merge. Then press next, and press the finish button. And again, hit that apply button. Piece of cake. Now let's try to do a brutal experiment. Do anything you want, like splitting the partition, resize it, etc. And at the end, let's try to recover its data. The data recovery feature is one of the best things we can use from this software. Let's try it out. Right-click the drive, then choose data recovery. Now let the software scan for missing data. It could take a long time to finish depending on your storage capacity. Just be patient. For me, it took about 1.5 hours to finish. So these are the lost data. You can select it all and save it to your computer. And you need to wait again for some time. And then you can press OK. And you can find your deleted data inside these folders. You might not get your lost file entirely, but at least you can try this method. I guess that's all I need to say about the Minitool Partition Wizard. If you love this software as much as I do, you can try buying it. Anyway, thanks for watching this video and see you later.